Hello everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. I am Frederick and this video we're going to talk about one of the important aspects of ASP.NET Core, and that is what we call as Blazor. So we're going to talk about Blazor. This whole tutorial is about 30 plus and I'm going to make it short and very simple as well. This video is going to be from the scratch to advanced, so anyone can actually have a look at it and it's going to benefit the person as well. So this video is going to be the best out of all, so be with me whilst you move on to with this video. And now by the end of this, the whole video, you're able to design your own best website with ASP.NET Core, with Blazor, and also to integrate some components, configure and use with the sync fusion. So stick with me whilst you move on. Let's get back to business, okay? All right, so now this video we're going to talk about, that is the ASP.NET Core Blazor tutorial. So first of all, I have a note that's going to actually help us to explain, because I cannot be saying it orally like that. We need to have a written one where you can also read from, right? And I have a note for you, okay? And now I'm using the Visual Studio Code to as my note editor. So that's what I'm using to write a note. So first of all, what is ASP.NET Core 5? ASP.NET Core 5. I know by now you've heard of ASP.NET, .NET Framework, .NET Core 3.1, .NET 5, .NET 6, .NET 7. So you're actually confused, right? Don't worry. We're going to cover it. You're going to understand everything in this video. So first of all, what is the question, the answer to this question? What is the ASP.NET Core 5? So to understand this, we need to also understand .NET Framework. So when you say .NET Framework, what is it? .NET Core, what is it? .NET 5 or 6 or 7, what is it? And 1.NET, what is it? So that's what we're going to take a look in this video. So first of all, let's tackle the first one. What is ASP.NET Framework? So that is the first version of this framework is what? .NET Framework 1.0. And this framework was released in February 2002. That is the old one. Currently, we have the latest version of 4.8, I think so, and this was released in April 2019. So, .NET Framework is built for only Windows, so meaning that you can only use to build application that can run on Windows platform. It is not cross-platform to support Linux and Mac. I hope when talk about .NET Framework, I hope this is clear. So when you see .NET Framework 1.0, 4.8, and etc., they are built for only Windows application. So you can use that to develop only Windows application. Take note. Now let's go to what is .NET Core. That's the point two, .NET Core. Now the first version of the .NET, that is the .NET Core 1.0, was released in June 2016. Currently, the latest version is what we have, .NET Core 3.1. So .NET Core 3.1, that is the latest version that was released. And now this is a cross-platform, meaning it can use to build application to run on all platforms such as Windows, Mac, and Linux. Take note, .NET Framework is for only Windows applications. .NET Core is for what? For both Windows, Mac, and Linux. Then, if so, then what is .NET 5? Now, that is the next major release after .NET Core 3.1. The current version of the .NET, the current one is .NET 7.0. So you can see, when you go to .NET, you can see we have 7.0 as the current version. So you can see, build any app with .NET. And when you go to download, you can see we have the current version as for 7.0. We have 6.0 and 5.0. So the current version is for 7.0 as I speak, 2022. Okay, and this was released in what? That is November 8th, 2022. So last November, and that was what it was released. Okay, so release also November 8, 2022. That's the .NET 6. So we have 6 and we have 7. These are released in the same date. So you see that they are available now. All right, so let's continue on. Now, this has feature combination of .NET Framework and .NET Core 3.1. So we diffuse the .NET Core, which run on all the platforms, and .NET Framework, which runs only on the Windows platform. They fuse all features together, and now they've built it as a .NET Core 5, or .NET 5, .NET 6, .NET 7. Okay, so when you see .NET 5, .NET 6 or 7, that is a updated version of .NET Core 3.1. Take note. Now, what you have to know. So when you talk about ASP.NET Core 5.0, it's the same as .NET 5. Okay, so we can say now currently we have .NET, the current version for .NET 5 is .NET 6 and 7. And also, when we talk about framework, we talk about Entity Framework Core 5.0. It's the same as Entity Framework Core in .NET 5.0. Okay, so it's also the same. Take note. Then, what is One.NET? So, Microsoft want to create unified runtime system, putting all together to have one solid system, which comprises of all frameworks, assemblies, and etc. So, you see, all that we talk about, the frameworks and all this core. So they wanted to put everything together. As soon as you download that, you're going to have everything intact, and that's what we call as a .NET 1.NET. So with this, it supports desktop applications, that is the WPF, window forms, web design, that is for ASP.NET. So ASP, we have .NET. Now cloud base is for who? So cloud is for Azure. We have mobile for Xamarin, gaming, Internet of Things, that's IoT, AI version, and we have all this. And we have AI too, artificial intelligence. Okay, so now with the .NET 6, 5.0, 6.0, 7.0, it supports all these features that can use to create these applications upon all platforms, not only for Windows. So note, .NET 5.0 and above are only compatible with the Visual Studio 2019 version of 16.9 and above. So you have to check. The version is supposed to be 16.9. And above. So how do you use this command prompt to check? So first of all, you can actually launch the Visual Studio to check the version of it. Okay, you go to the Visual Studio, go to help, then you go to about Visual Studio, so you can check over there. Or you can use the command prompt, so window key plus R, pass in CMD, and now you have to type in .NET dash version. So .NET then dash version. So you could see that the current version I have for my computer is 7.0. So you can use that to check the version of it. All right, so in this video, we'll be also using the Sync Fusion Blazor component. And this Sync Fusion Blazor component, what is it? So that is a video that you saw over here, or the image. So that's the Sync Fusion Blazor component. Now this support a lot of components. So as you can see from here, so you can see you can use this one to design a first or nice UI component, and it supports data grid, charts, scheduler, and etc. So as you can see from here, we have grid, data visualization, calendars, drop downs, file viewer, editor, document processing libraries, navigation, input buttons, and etc. Okay, so all these are being provided by the Sync Fusion. So in a video, we'll be taking a look at this Sync Fusion while blending the Sync Fusion component with the Blazor as well in this video. So I bet you this video is going to be one of the best and going to be interesting to watch. And by the end of this video, you're going to grab a lot of concepts and ideas from this. My question is, why do you have to use Sync Fusion component? One, they have over 70 plus components for even only Blazors. Because if you actually check from here, you can see from the Blazor side, you can see it has almost 80 plus. So you can see it has access over 80 plus lightweight, responsive, touch-friendly components for Blazor. So this includes components like Grid, Charts, Scheduler, and Tree View. Okay, free to access the ebooks on Blazor, ASP.NET Core, and related technologies. So it has a lot that we can actually depend on. So that's the reason why we are going to use that. It supports both Blazor server side and client side. So you want to process at the client side, possible. You want to process at the server side, is it possible? Now it has good documentation and limited access support too. So as you know, it is very easy to integrate, configure, and use. Free to use with their community license as well. So as you can see from here, if you want to download, you can see we have download free trial. It's free as well. You can actually use that in your application too. All right, so this is what we're going to take a look in the whole video. So bear with me. Let's take a break. When we return, we're going to move on to the next one with the Blazor. Thank you guys for watching. I'm going to catch you up in the next video after break.